The Duke and Duchess of Sussex joined Global Citizen Live on the Great Lawn of Central Park in New York City on September 25 to continue their work with world leaders in pursuit of global vaccine equity, according to the international advocacy organization Global Citizen. Harry and Meghan are known as the Duchess of Sussex. Prince Harry and Princess Meghan are known as the Prince and Princess Without Borders. They left their roles as taxpayer-funded royals. They continue to make impact. The inspirational power couple royal duo is known for doing work that matters. The main vehicle of their work is Archewell Foundation. When Prince Harry walked on the Global Citizen 2021 stage with his wife Meghan in hand, they received a rapturous applause. Across the pond, it was evident that they had transcended from mere royals to global statespeople. Their speeches were electrifying, and the crowd roared in appreciation for the work they put in to help achieve vaccine equity, proving that service is universal. In times of crisis, people are looking for leadership. Meghan and Harry have risen to the challenge. Meghan and Harry appeared with Amina Mohammed, Deputy Secretary General of the United Nations, and Dr. Tedros Adhanom Ghebreyesus, Director General of the World Health Organization, as part of the global broadcast event. The call to action was for a once-in-a-generation day of global unity. Over 100 countries have endorsed a proposal to waive intellectual property rights around the production of COVID-19 vaccines and other medical tools. Pfizer, BioNTech, and Moderna have agreed to share mRNA technology with the new WHO-sponsored mRNA technology transfer hub based in South Africa. The G7 had committed to sharing at least 1 billion COVID-19 vaccine doses immediately with those in greatest need. Meghan and Harry believe that compassion is the defining cultural force of the 21st century, and through their work they support a growing community of partner organizations fueling systemic cultural change. At Archewell Foundation, they listen to people in their communities, help them tell their stories, put real action behind words, and spotlight a new generation of leadership. During a work trip to Manhattan, Prince Harry and Meghan Markle met with the United States Ambassador to the United Nations to address vaccine equity and racial justice. "It was a pleasure to meet Prince Harry and Meghan Markle, the Duke and Duchess of Sussex," Ambassador Linda Thomas Greenfield tweeted. "Important discussion about COVID, racial justice, and improving mental health awareness." Thomas Greenfield, a longtime diplomat, shared photos of the pair chatting with her on a white couch and posing next to an American flag at the United Nations headquarters in New York City's East Village. The United States had pledged 500 million vaccines to assist developing nations with vaccines to protect precious life. "We know that only 4% of Africans have access to the vaccine." The Duke and Duchess of Sussex met with the UN ambassador and talked about vaccine equity. At the Global Citizen Concert, UN Ambassador Linda Thomas Greenfield announced an additional 500 million doses. "As the Duke and Duchess said, we need to stop the spread and get vaccines to everyone. That is why President Biden announced this week that we're donating another 500 million vaccine doses to the world. That brings our total donations to 1.1 billion doses. Harry and Meghan raised more than $53.8 million to secure 10 million vaccines for disadvantaged countries and communities. The Duke and Duchess of Sussex raised over $3 million for vaccine equity to fight the spread of COVID-19 and save lives. The $3 million raised was in celebration of Archie's birthday, a life being lived with purpose. Leadership is influence. The impact of the work that the Duke and Duchess Meghan are doing is saving lives. They are now funded by the British taxpayer, yet Harry and Meghan are doing work that matters. The other royals are silent as people are dying across the Commonwealth from COVID-19. The royal couple visited New York City on Friday, following a visit to One World Trade Center, the iconic tower of the reconstructed World Trade Center. They met with City Mayor Bill de Blasio and his family at the observatory in the tower, where New York Governor Kathy Hochul accompanied them. A group of world health and political leaders convened to discuss strategies for achieving COVID-19 vaccination parity and addressing the core causes of other global health imbalances. Harry and Meghan were among those there. Earlier in the year, the Duchess of Sussex convened the private sector to join Vax Live. Global Citizen saw wonderful commitments as a result. MasterCard committed $25 million to ensure equitable access to COVID-19 vaccines across the globe, partnering with Global Citizen Vax Live campaign. In New York, the gathering brought together a number of world leaders, health officers, and specialists, including Chelsea Clinton, WHO Assistant Director General Stuart Simonson, Director of World Affairs at the Department of Health and Human Services Lois Tempo, CEO of the World Health Organization Anil Sawhney, WHO Director General Dr. Tedros Adhanom Ghebreyesus, former Liberian President Ellen Johnson Sirleaf, and the UN's Undersecretary General Winnie Byanyima at the United Nations. Harry and Meghan said they were excited to do their part to support COVID-19 vaccine equity after meeting with the foremost leaders on public health, pandemic preparedness, scientific progress, and community building. The communique from the group expressed an appreciation for the opportunity to hear from some of the well-respected professionals who are working relentlessly to bring this pandemic to an end. Harry and Meghan have had conversation with global leaders to strengthen their commitment to vaccination equity. They were very inspired by the spirit of collaboration and contributed their own ideas. Dr. Tedros Adhanom Ghebreyesus, Director General of the World Health Organization, WHO, expressed gratitude to Prince Harry and Meghan Markle, the Duchess of Sussex, for their attendance at the United Nations General Assembly. "We strongly believe in self-optimization, becoming the best version of ourselves. Using talents and skills for purpose, profit, and philanthropy, and doing work that makes impact and builds communities. This is the reason we support the work of the Duke and Duchess of Sussex, doing work that matters, saving lives." If you liked this video, make sure you give it a thumbs up and share it with your friends. Also subscribe to the Duchess of Impact channel, and don't forget to hit that bell icon, so you never miss any updates. If you believe in our work and would like to support us, consider joining our channel membership by clicking join. What do you think of our video? Let us know in the comment section below. If you enjoyed this video and want to hear from me again, be sure to hit that subscribe button before you go. Thanks for watching.